This video is everything you need to know about the metronome inside of Pro Tools. Hello, my name is Malcolm Owen-Flood. I teach DIY audio things here on YouTube, so please do subscribe if that sounds like it's your sort of thing. And as I said, I want to discuss the metronome inside of Pro Tools because sometimes it's the simple things that trick us up the most. And I wanted to make a video that showed pretty well everything you could need to know about it. It's going to be shorter than you think. It's going to be to the point. I'm just going to try and blaze through a bunch of different things that you can do with the metronome and how to control it to get it to do what you want, because it can be frustrating. And we've probably all had a drummer that has had some weird metronome request. So let's just jump into it. First thing, I've just launched a blank session. I've made a master fader so I can control that, but you can ignore that. And usually Pro Tools creates a click track on command when you make a new session. So you should already hear a click as soon as you launch your session. But if you didn't, just go up to track, and at the very bottom, there's a great click track button. And if I click that, see, it just made a new one for me. So that will always work as well. And then from there, you'll just have to make sure that the output is going to somewhere that you can actually hear. So we've got a click track, but we need it to be at the tempo we want. And that is done by going up to the tempo on this top section here and clicking this plus icon. If you can't see that, just go up to this bars and beats drop down menu and click it, and then make sure tempo is selected. Once you've clicked the plus icon on the tempo bar there, you now have this meter where you can select the tempo you want. Let's go with 130 today, and we can decide where that starts. So this is going to be the very start of the session, which is 99% of the time going to be what you want. But it's worth noting that if you have tempo changes, if you select somewhere else in the song and now click that, that tempo change will happen at that location. So if you want to have one tempo for the whole song, just make sure you're at the very beginning of the session when you make your tempo. And then one bonus tip, and this is actually probably the coolest thing about the metronome app in general, is that you can tap the tempo. So if you've got, say, a drummer or guitarist handy and they want to just play the song without a tempo, you can just get them to play. And as they're playing that, you can just tap the T button on your keyboard in time with them, and that will set the tempo. But first you need to go and select the tempo up in the top right here, and then just start tapping T. And you can see it adjusts in real time as I tap it. Cool, we landed on 111 there. So then we could play that for our drummer to hear. And they're like, great, that's the perfect tempo, but I want there to be no accents. Okay, that changes things yet again. Now we just go to the Metronome plugin, which is inserted on our click track. And inside of here, we can change everything about how it sounds. So first thing to notice is that the sound profile is in these drop-down menus here. And we've got our accent click on the top, and all of the other clicks in the measure are down below here. So in the case of wanting them all to sound the same, we could just go down to the bottom option here and change this to classic click accent, which means that it has the same sound as the click above. So now we shouldn't hear any difference between all of the clicks. Some people really prefer that. And now it's worth mentioning that there's a ton of sounds in here. Right, you can really find whatever works for them. And sometimes you do need to work on that and just get something that pierces through the arrangement of the song so they can really lock in. 9 times out of 10, I just stay with the classic. From there, we can actually change the volume of each hit. Or we can even change the subdivision of each hit. But to do that, we have to click this follow meter button. So now we've disengaged that and we kind of have control to play with it. So you can really get creative and really make it whatever you want inside of that framework. Now, another cool trick with the metronome is that you don't always want to hear it. And you can, of course, mute the track just like any other track. But what I actually prefer to do is control this metronome option up here. And you can do that by clicking it. Or if you want to be a Pro Tools Pro, you click 7 on the number pad of your keyboard. And you can throw that in and out in real time as you're playing. So if you want somebody to play without a click for a certain part, you can toggle it in and out in real time. Conversely, if you want to just toggle it off when you're doing playback versus when you're recording, you can do that manually as well. But what if you want to do that automatically? Of course, there is a way. So check this out. Up here in this tempo meter display, we have a few different options. First thing I want you to do is double click where it says 2 bars. And that brings this click count off options menu. And we can set our click to play during play and record, or only during record, or only during count off. So that means that if I'm on only during record, if I click play, we would be listening to the song, but we're not hearing a click track right now. But if I click record, we of course do hear the click. So we can set that to be whatever our preferred workflow is as well, which can be really great. One last thing to think about. Now, what about count off? Count off is when you want to click preceding the recording. So we can select how many bars of count off we want. Let's go with one bar, click OK, and then we turn it on by clicking count off here. And now when I click record, you will hear that we hear the click for a full bar before it starts recording. And that just lets the musician have a chance to get into the tempo before the song actually starts. Now, the last pro tip I want to give you with the metronome is for when you have somebody that really wants something odd, like maybe they don't want the accent on the one, they want it on the four, which has happened to me. Here is how you do that, because the app itself won't really let you. So to do that, we can just commit the click track and then edit it as we want. So let me show you. I'm just going to default our click back to usual. So we should hear an accent followed by four lower beeps. Perfect. Now we commit it. You can do whatever you need here, but I usually do render the volume mute automation, and then we can hide and make an active. There we go. We've now got a click track as an audio file rather than as just the plugin, which is great because now with our grid enabled, go to grid mode, we can just cut these up and then make whatever order we want. So if I wanted the accent to be on the last beat of the bar, I could just copy those around and now our bar would be inverted. But say they want the accent on 2 and 4. Well, that's easy. We just grab beat 4 now and move it to 2 as well. And then I can just duplicate this along, or even better, option R will let you repeat it for 100 measures. Bam, we got a click like that through the entire song. So you can really customize it whatever way you want, which is super awesome. In addition, having it as an audio file is real great because we can just highlight sections and command M to mute them or delete them entirely if we want to remove clicks for sections of the song. So very powerful. And I think that's pretty well everything you're going to need to know about the metronome inside of Pro Tools for now anyways. If you enjoyed this, please give this video a thumbs up. That helps the video get out there and helps my channel grow very much and is super appreciated. And if you want to learn how to do some mixing, I do have a free mixing workshop down below called Standout Mixes from the Self-Recording Band, which is a podcast that I co-host. So do check that out as well. It's totally free, teaches you to level up your own mixes with the plugins you already own, so you don't have to buy anything. So please check that out. And if you want to keep learning, check out one of these videos.